Now I can't run anything yet. This is grayed out because I haven't selected my connection. So I'm going to start by selecting built-in. As we mentioned before, this means I'm connected to serverless. And I'm going to start again just by running a basic query here. So we'll go run this. And you'll see here that this is a little different than I did last time. What this has done is it's got some wildcards. It's actually got three wildcards in it. And that's because there's the hierarchical structure under here has multiple years. These years are broken into months. And then there's a name, multiple files, dot with a parquet extension at the end. And so what this is telling serverless is to look at the totality of a hierarchical file and folder system, starting at effectively the root here is yellow, and then any wildcards that match this pattern, and just give me the top 100 rows. That's what's happened here. And so we get the 100 results back here, and you can see what that looks like. So I'm going to scroll down here now that we've got that, and you can see there's a couple of other examples. They're very similar. One is for public holiday data, one is for weather data. But by and large, it's exactly the same query. It's got the same wildcards, different amounts of wildcards, but functionally the same thing. So I'm not going to run those. I want to move down to something a little more complex and introduce a keyword called file path. So what you can see here is a slightly more complicated query because we're adding some group bys and what have you. At the very top, we've got standard SQL functions. So the year function to extract the year out of a datetime or datetime to type, and count is just count. The open row set remains consistent. We've got the wildcards that we just talked about above. The format is parquet. But this file path keyword is interesting. Right? This is not a column name. This is a keyword in serverless that enables us to leverage the partition elimination capabilities off the file system in the data lake itself. Now, partition elimination has for a long time, particularly in analytics scenarios, been a fantastic feature for accelerating performance. Partitions enable you to effectively structure your ranges of data within a table, and the optimizer can use metadata to understand the guarantees of what data will exist within each partition, and at query runtime can simply ignore a number of partitions in a table, which could represent a lot of data and a large amount of I/O, and zero in on a partition. And fact tables in data warehouses and SQL Server were a great example of where partitioning was commonly applied. They also gave you some malleability with things like switching and merging and splitting, which we won't go into here, but great partitioning features as well. What FilePath does is effectively enables you to do the same thing, but here we're telling the query to filter based on a folder name instead of metadata in the database itself. And so what you can see here, if I go run this query, is that I've got everything that I just mentioned, but I'm asking the FilePath with a parameter of 1 to look for everything greater than 2009 and less than 2010. So in this scenario, this 1 right here is mapping to the first instance of my wildcard, which is probably sort of intuitive in the sense that 2009 is clearly a year, but there's a couple of other parameters here as well. And so although in the storage system, maybe we've got years 2000 through 2020, we've been able to accelerate this query by filtering in just on 2009, 2010 using the file path keyword. Now, to give you a better example of what this looks like, what I'll actually go do is show you file path. I can actually use it outside of the where clause in the select as well. And so what I'll actually do is put in file path, and I need to put the NYC at the front of that as well. And I can run file path with no parameters, or I can put in NYC file path and give it the one that we're referencing below as well. Now, because I'm running an aggregate, of course, I just need to grab these and I need to put them into my group by clause. I'll just put them right in here and we'll tighten it up a little bit because I like to try to the limit that I can anyway, keep my code kind of tidy. And so where our previous result set showed this, I'm actually going to go run this now. And this will run for a little bit. But what you'll see here is that I can actually grab, what did I miss here? Oh, I typed it slightly wrong here to show you that it's all real. We'll fix that up and run it again. And while this runs, what you're going to see is I'm going to get two additional columns back, of course, for file path and file path one. And you'll see the value for file path without the parameter is effectively the full path to the file. And then the one will show you, hopefully, just the value 2009. And so it's important to note here that it's really picking up everything after the equal sign in this asterisk is what's running here. And so that's the 2009 here. Had I moved this, and I won't run this, but just to sort of provide a better example, had I moved this to change it to something like that, where I'm bringing the asterisk in and eliminating equals, all I'd really need to do then is put equals in here. So there's an element of sort of concatenating the value together to produce the string, but it just gives you an example of what's actually happening under the covers. I won't go do that. I'll put the equals back up here, but it gives you tremendous flexibility. And you could imagine perhaps, you know, other patterns as well, that you've got multiple asterisk wildcards in that single path location. But as I mentioned, now we get the full path name back, which is kind of interesting. So that's where the data is, which we kind of already know. But you could sort of map the wildcards to it. So PU year equals 2009 is right there. We got the month, which is right there. And then we've actually got the parquet name right here. And these are all sort of highly variable, which is why the wildcard is useful. 2009 is exactly what we expect because we told it that NYC file path one needs to be greater than or equal to 2009. So that's what we have right here. And then back over here as well was the value that we had before. So we changed the aggregate, of course, because now I'm grouping by the file name. So maybe that's not super useful. Let me back this out a bit to where we were. So I'm going to go back to just the year and I'll back out my select statement as well. And I'm going to run this again. Because what I'd like to show you is how you can also flip from a tabular result set to look at these things visually as well. One of the things that we built into Synapse Studio is the ability to quickly visualize data within the studio. I'm personally quite guilty of cutting and pasting result sets from things like Management Studio and other tools into Excel to visualize the data. But at the bottom here, you can see we've got this simple toggle from table or chart. And so I'm going to click on this and I'm going to lift it up here. And it defaults to a line chart and actually put both the lines. This doesn't really help me too much. But on the right-hand side, I can control this. So my current series, or my category, I should say, is really the current year. That's what I want here. And then my chart, let's just make this a column. And so I can quickly start to actually see the values here. They're very similar. So it doesn't, the columns look very similar. It's given me the legend, the y-axis at a base of zero. But you can mouse over and you can obviously see the actual value, 170.8 million, 169, fraction over 169 million as well. And you could do more complicated charting, of course, if I had more complicated result sets, but just an example of how you can start to look at this. It's not at all a replacement for a more robust BI tool for visualization like Power BI. This is a developer who just wants to get a really quick glance at the data without sort of squinting at the numbers. It's actually a very useful feature. So I'll switch back to the table. That's pretty much everything I wanted to show in this section. This sample here has a set of other examples as well, still using the file path. It provides some additional examples on how to do different types of calculations over. You can see here we're using with, so common table expressions are supported within serverless SQL, as well as still using the open row set functionality, still using file path, as I mentioned. And then there's something a little bit more convoluted down here where we're getting into additional filtering here. So your multiple where clauses or multiple filters within the where clause, I should say, and then a whole bunch of aggregates being thrown in the data. I'm not gonna run these right now, but just to give you some examples that, really once you've got that open row set bulk and format defined, you've got tremendous flexibility with the T-SQL language and the ability to, of course, then visualize that locally in the studio or through tools such as Power BI. It's just it's just SQL after that.